yet who is listening to what the Quran is saying. Oh, people of the scriptures, why don't we come to a common ground and just say La ilaha illa Allah.
Come and refute me. Okay? But if you're going to be not refuting me and not apologizing, this will show your dishonesty. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Just quick reply to something I've seen on one of Kalam videos. You're going to see the bit I'm going to comment on. And this video by Kalam, it's about 1 hour, 20 minutes or something like this. This video is full of lies. If you know Islam, if you have studied Islam, you will know this man is is saying something untrue. But we are trying to help those who have not done studies in Islam and Quran to know why we think so, you know. And we hope Kalam can say, no, you are wrong. Quran support me. I want him to do this. Okay, and then I'm going to apologize, Kalam, for you. Okay. So, he said in his video, in Quran in Surah Ali Imran chapter 3, Surah 3, verse 64, he said, the verse says, O people of the scripture, let's come and believe La ilaha illallah. And then he gives the impression that the verse is calling for us just to believe La ilaha illallah, all of us, and be united. But looking at the verse, it doesn't say this. Actually, it say the opposite, that they are wrong and we're inviting them to what is right. Okay? This if they want to unite with us. Okay? And therefore, I understand from this verse, Kalam, that Quran is saying openly, people of the scripture are wrong and they are not worshipping the right God.
I'm the only one there yet who is listening to what the Quran is saying. Oh, people of the scriptures, why don't we come to a common ground and just say La ilaha illa Allah? No, it's not that. You have to say this and that and that, and you have and da 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 da. I'm saying, fam, let's come to a common understanding. Let, you know, the Trinity explain itself, your Tawheed explain itself. Let's see how there is some type of relationship between the two. No, we must cause division and divide and da 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 da. Alright, cool. That's up to you. I'm not even saying that. I'm just saying, let me actually understand your religion. Let me understand where you're coming from, Tawheed. Okay, I understand it. Let me understand the Christians' understanding. Okay, Trinity. Okay, I understand it. You all believe in one God. Jews, yeah, you all believe in one God. Okay, so what's the problem? To me, I'm just seeing it's the same thing. It's the same thing, but you just have different understanding because some people are just laymen. Anyways.
And here is the verse. قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْا إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا وبينكم ألا نعبد إلا الله ولا نشرك به شيئا. You have read the verse, say people of the scripture, and then he said, say لا إله إلا الله. Let's believe لا إله إلا الله. But the verse doesn't read this whatsoever. Okay? I will read the English straight away. It says here in my copy, which is everywhere, and I believe your own copy will be saying this Kalam as well, and I want you to apologize or come and refute me. Okay? But if you're going to be not refuting me and not apologizing, this will show your dishonesty for your audience and inshallah for everyone sees this video. Okay? The verse says, Say, O people of the scripture, come to a word that is equitable between us and you, that we will not worship except Allah and not associate anything with him and not take one another as lords instead of Allah. But if they turn away, then say, bear witness that we are Muslims. Okay. So Kalam, where it says about let's be united, just believe La ilaha illallah. The verse doesn't say let's be united, believe la ilaha illallah. The verse is saying let's come and worship no one except Allah. I.e., I understand that the Quran inviting them to worship no one than Allah, then they are worshiping somebody else than Allah. Okay? And if they turn away, we should say to them, bear witness that we are Muslims, i.e., worshiping Allah alone. The problem Kalam have, and I hope he's going to get it this time, because it's going to solve all his problems. Kalam think, La ilaha illallah means there is no God but Allah. No, Kalam. This is not the right translation. La ilaha illallah means there is no one worthy of worship except Allah. It doesn't mean there is no God but Allah. It means there is no one worthy of worship except Allah. This is the meaning of La ilaha illallah according to Muslims. Okay, because anyone will say La ilaha illallah, but Jesus is Allah in flesh. So therefore, I believe La ilaha illallah. Who is Jesus? And your paganism, your Kemetic. I'm from Egypt, Kalam, and I've been to many temples. I've seen your your ancestors, which I believe they are not really, because you are from Nigeria. I don't know how this happens that you are in Nigeria, very far away, and your ancestors are those who lived in Egypt. But maybe you migrated your grandparents. But your ancestors, they have gods for every area. Okay, every region in ancient Egypt has its own special god, and there is a god over all the country. Okay. And there is hierarchy of gods. So these people, they had more than one god. Even they say, they believe La ilaha illallah, that yeah, Allah is the only god. But they also associate their gods to be god as well. They say La ilaha illallah, but this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is also represented in other gods that represent him. He is one god, but he has many representations. Okay, many other so-called gods that also is Allah. And you can pick and choose anyone to represent Allah for you. Cobra, snake, monkey, ram, cat, beetle. You can choose your God that represents the one God for you. This is your paganism, Kalam. And this is not monotheism. La ilaha illallah means Allah only, God the creator, to be the one of that we worship. This is the meaning of La ilaha illallah. Okay. I hope this makes sense. And inshallah, I'm looking forward for your reply, if you can reply, Kalam. If you can't reply, then please correct yourself and learn something about the meaning of La ilaha illallah.